This tutorial is based on using Adobe Premiere as a coloring tool, while providing a detailed demonstration on how to color D-Cinelike footage. What is displayed is raw footage shot with D-Cinelike. First, go to Workspaces and select Color. Open Lumetri Scopes on the left side of the interface, which helps you to read the colors and correct the exposure of the footage. Observe the current brightness of the footage through the RGB waveform type. It shows that all three color channels are basically the middle tone, not over or underexposed. After analyzing the raw footage, it's time to start primary corrections. Open Basic Correction. Drag the black slider to the left to trim the blacks. Next, drag the whites to the right to increase the white points. And then drag the shadow slider to the left to darken the shadows. And slide the highlights a bit to the right to increase the highlight, enhancing the sense of depth. Last, strengthen the color contrast to further distinguish shadows and highlights. Open Color Wheels and Match, pull down the middle tone and push up the highlight to increase the contrast of the footage. Go back to Basic Correction. Click the WB selector under the white balance and take samples from the white or gray part in the footage. Then slide the temperature and tint to the left to make the color temperature cooler and the hue bluer, as they should be. Next, increase the saturation of the footage to make colors more vivid. Coloring is mostly done after primary correction. Let's do color grading for even more creativity and details. First, we are going to apply a Lumetri color look, which is convenient for post-processing. Next, open the RGB curves. Click on the curves directly and drag around to adjust the tint, giving a punch of contrast to the footage. Next, open the hue versus hue curve. Find the blue part of the curve and adjust it up to cyan. The blue and green on the screen are increasing, and the color of the sky gradually appears cyan after mixing. Switch back to hue versus saturation curve. Increase the saturation of the blue sky to create a sense of depth. Last, switch to hue versus luma curve and pull down the brightness of yellow and blue to align the hue of the footage as a whole. Open the HSL secondary controls. Since the main color of the clouds is white, click the white color swatches, selecting this preset color as a starting point. Then isolate the clouds by directly adjusting the range of luminance in the qualifier, for the reason that the clouds are in the highlight part with clearly high luminance. Slide the denoise to the right to soften the clouds, and increase the blur to make the clouds better blend in the sky. Then, adjust the temperature and pull down the contrast and saturation to add more details to the clouds and make the sky clearer. Click Creativity and increase the sharpness to make the depths and details more prominent. Apply another Lumetri color look and frame the figures in the footage with the free draw bezier for follow-up adjustments. Increase exposure first. Pull down the contrast and bring up the highlight and shadow. Then we are going to track the targets by using mask tracking and click the mask path setting under the mask. When the tracking is over, you may need to adjust it a little bit. The last step is to add a vignette effect to the footage. Open Vignette, adjust the parameters so that the figures in the middle stand out. Looking back at this tutorial, we first finished primary corrections, correcting the colors as they're supposed to be in camera, and then perform creative stylized color grading. Last, do the color grading for even more details. Hit the like button if this tutorial was helpful. If you need any support with your DJI gear, feel free to contact us via Facebook Messenger by following the link in the description. Thank you for watching.